Hey guys, hope you're doing well. Today I'm back with another project. I have two different solutions here, which actually have the same application used for stripping solder from the PCB boards and clean all the soldering parts or from the gold-plated pins before I start processing with nitric acid to prevent formation of metastatic acid. Before starting, I want to thank you all guys for supporting me. My channel just reached to 1000 subscribers and I just wanted to share with you guys my rejoicing. This two solution, this one is based on the urea nitrate solution that I actually don't prefer this because urea nitrate is kinda energetic material that I don't prefer to handle this. And this solution is based on the ammonium quaternary salt and nitric acid. This is the main solution that I want to show you guys.
So, let's start.
Alright, to make these two different solutions, this is what we need: urea, citric acid, nitric acid, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, and ferric nitrate solution, and cetrimide. Actually, cetrimide is an ammonium quaternary salt which is used as a disinfectant. This is a 15% solution. I want to use this as an inhibitor. As I said, it is a ammonium quaternary salt solution which causes to protect copper and gold plating layers and slow down dissolution rate of other metal and only dissolve solder or tin from the electronics. So these are for urea based solution and this is for cetrimide based solution. First I start with making cetrimide solution. To this volumetric flask I add some, actually this is a 65 milliliters of nitric acid which is 50% concentrated. And this is a ferric nitrate solution, 78% concentrated. I just made this by dissolving some iron pieces in nitric acid. You need to keep track of iron which you are using to make this solution to be able to calculate a ferric nitrate solution concentration. This is 78% which I made. You only need 12.5 milliliters of this solution. There is something to mention why I'm using ferric nitrate solution, because solder which is covered the copper on the PCB board or gold plated pins forms an alloy with copper. Actually this is a copper and tin metal alloy which is hard to be dissolved in hydrochloric acid and urea based solution which widely used with refiners. So I add this to accelerate process and dissolve copper and tin alloy which is formed by passing the time which the PCB is manufactured. I will add hydrochloric acid at the end because I don't want nitrosyl ion to be formed, actually which is formed in aqua regia when comes in contact with nitric acid. I first add cetrimide. We need 32 milliliters. All these amounts that I'm saying is for making 250 milliliters of thin stripping solution. Now we just need 2.5 milliliters of hydrochloric acid. Now we need just to add water to back up this solution to this line to make 250 milliliters of solution. I'm using distilled water for this purpose. Alright, now we just need to mix this solution. Then I transfer solution to a beaker. In fact, this is my main solution, which I want to show its advantages over urea-based solution or dilute hydrochloric acid, which is widely used by refiners to clean soldering from the PCBs or gold-plated pins. To make second solution, first some distilled water been added and then 10 grams of citric acid and 15 grams of urea been dissolved in water. Afterwards, I started pouring 65 milliliters of 50% concentrated nitric acid into the solution. As you observe, solution turned muddy. This is urea nitrate precipitate, which is formed. This substance is the reason which makes me avoid using this regularly. Solution cloudy appearance could be fixed by addition of some hot water. I placed beaker on the hot plate to help with dissolving crystals. Now that I have solutions prepared, I also wanted to prepare some PCB boards, computer parts, and gold-plated pins to be tested with thin stripping solution. In first place, ammonium quaternary-based solution been poured over the first pin and then urea-based solution added to the second pin for comparison. After a few minutes, pin soldering started to get dark, which means tin was being dissolved and gold plating remained untouched. Same was happening to the urea-soaked pins. At meantime, pins were soaked into the solutions, I decided to dip some PCBs into the solution to check their ability to dissolve widely soldered area. In the left solution, bubbles started coming up, which means tin was being dissolved. While no bubbles were forming in the right-sided solution, which seems tin the solution rate was much slower. In this time lapse, which been captured in 45 minutes, high efficiency of ammonium quaternary based solution is obvious, and it easily dissolves solder area cause underneath copper section turnout. Also, IC chips been detached only after a few minutes. Also, in urea-based solution, some IC chips been detached after 45 minutes, but urea nitrate crystals started growing on the PCBs. The important point about urea-based solution was that it wasn't able to clean soldering from the PCBs. In the left solution, only thick solder part wasn't stripped completely in 45 minutes. So I let it sit for 1 hour, then it's been cleaned perfectly. Also, CPU pins were detached perfectly and gold plating had not been damaged. CPU pins were sunk into the solution, and the good news is that despite having high concentration of nitric acid in the solution, there is no trace of metastatic acid at the bottom of beaker.
pins and icy chips are pretty nice and neat. Pins which been soaked earlier into the solution were detached completely. Also second pin been detached but a bit harder than the first pins. Which means ammonium quaternary based solution removed pins much better and cleaner. Moreover, I used this solution to clean tin out of some gold plated pins and MLCCs, which worked great. And as is evident, tin stripped successfully and brass part exposed while keeping gold intact. PCB board placed in ammonium quaternary solution for 1 hour and here is the result. Tin been dissolved completely and copper left behind. Because cetrimide preserve copper and act as inhibitor. As cetrimide only lower the solution rate of copper, copper will get dissolved eventually but very slowly, so electronic part shouldn't be left in solution for a long time. When solution turn green, this means we have some copper dissolved. Also I observe after turning solution green, its ability to dissolve tin metal was reduced. Urea based solution placed on the hot plate for crystals to be dissolved. So I could check for presence of metastatic acid afterwards. You may wondering why I have used too much urea which caused urea nitrate precipitate out. Well, I did it to prevent formation of metastatic acid and just in case for copper to not get dissolved. Fortunately, there wasn't any metastatic acid form in urea based solution either. To hang on the conclusion, urea based solution wasn't completely successful and had some disadvantages. Firstly, it is a dangerous compound to handle and secondly, it wasn't able to dissolve tin completely. But cetrimide based solution worked pretty good.
And here is the final result achieved from the solution I've made based on cetrimide as an inhibitor and nitric acid, and this is the urea based solution which wasn't able to clean solder out of the PCB completely, and this is the solution I prefer over all other possible ways to dissolve solder like hydrochloric acid or urea nitrate based solution. And there we go. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. See you next time.